ClarkNet. ClarkNet was an internet service provider ISP located in Ellicott City, Maryland, that began operation in April 1993. It was the first ISP local to the Baltimore area and the second ISP native to Maryland. Operations ceased during 2003. The company's incorporated name was Clark Internet Services, Inc. The service was called ClarkNet, and it operated under the domain name of ClarkNet. ClarkNet was founded by Jamie Clark. It was located on the Clark family farm, located between Clarksville, Maryland, and Columbia, Maryland, and initially operated out of a working cow barn. Jamie Clark is deaf, and most of the early employees were also deaf. As the company grew, the offices moved to Columbia, and the computer data center remained at the barn. ClarkNet was a pioneer in many areas. It was the first ISP to provide dial-up TCP/IP access via SLIP or PPP targeted for the home user in the Mid-Atlantic region. It was one of the first web servers in the world, listed by CERN as one of the first 100 web servers in existence and one of the first in the country to offer free web pages to its customers. It was the first ISP to provide local dial-in access numbers to all of Baltimore and many parts of Maryland. It was the second ISP native to Maryland. It was the country's first only deaf-owned and operated ISP. It pioneered the use of Centrex ISTN, which is a 24/7 dedicated flat-rate ISTN line. It hosted, for a time, one of the top 10 root Usenet servers. ClarkNet enjoyed a great deal of press exposure because of its early entry into the Internet, the fact it was a deaf-owned company, its unusual location on a working farm, and its excellent reputation for service. Washington, D.C. area institutions used ClarkNet as their first exposure to the Internet, which included, among many others, NPR National Public Radio, sans the Sans Institute, and The Washington Post. Jamie Clark was interviewed and pictured in Fortune magazine and was the subject of a feature spot on NPR. ClarkNet was the largest dial-up provider in the Baltimore/Washington area for a time. It won several awards, such as Small Business Administration Awards. The company employed up to 80 people at its largest. The company was structured with 5 primary teams: engineering, customer service, sales and marketing, web development, accounting, along with a senior management team and a board of directors. ClarkNet also rolled out a training curriculum for individuals and businesses to teach basic to advanced courses in web development and internet research. Services provided included dial-up TCP/IP, dial-up shell access, dedicated circuits such as ISTN, Tone Frame Relay SMDS, web hosting, web development, colocation hosting. At its largest, it had over 20,000 dial-up customers and 2,000 dedicated customers. ClarkNet was purchased by Vireo in late 1997, but retained a large degree of local autonomy and continued to grow under the Vireo brand with many of the original ClarkNet employees in place. Vireo was sold to NTT in 2000, by which time the product focus had shifted away from dial-up and dedicated internet access to web hosting, and most of the original ClarkNet staff, products, and network were let go, dismantled, or sold respectively over the 2000-2003 period. The barn on the Clark farm where ClarkNet started burned down in an accident on November 15, 2004, although the company was no longer in existence nor being used by Vireo at the time.